Good morning, students. Welcome back to the second videos of this chapter. That is chapter number 8, cells and cell structures and function. And in the previous videos, we have discussed about different types of cell and size, different type and size of the cell. We have also discussed about variations of the cells and cell structure, cell set, and we have discussed about some topic about on the amoeba also, and this is how we have introduction. We have discussed the then we have discussed about discovery of the cell, then varieties in the cell numbers, size in cell, and today in this chapter we will discuss about the structures and structure and function. Under the structure and function, we will discuss a part of the cell. Okay. So under the part of cells, we'll be subdividing the videos into two parts again. We will be discussing the part of the cell, which is three important part of the cell, and then we'll discuss about the organelles which is present inside the cell. That will be discussed in the separate video lectures, and then we will discuss about the difference between plants and animal cells. Then we'll discuss about the prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Okay, so these are the topics which have been left. So in the next video lectures, next two video lectures, we'll try to cover up the chapters. Okay, so let's go to the parts of the cell. Before this, we see, a varieties of the organisms which are present around us. Okay, this organism, whether it's plants or animals or a different in shape and size that we have learned about in appearance, but all those organisms carried out a similar functions or numbers of functions, which may seem like nutritions, respirations and growth and reproductions. Okay, thus like in a plant, leaf perform the functions of synthesizing of foods. Okay, in a leaf, like in a plant, the leaf work as a producers or as a function to synthesize the foods. Similarly in animals, okay, our mouth involving in digging the foods, okay, through their cells, the cell of the cell in the leaf and the cell of the cell in the mouth are different, but the function that performed by the leaves and the mouths are same, but the function that carried out by the mouths in the plant animals and the leaf in the plants are same, because as leaf will perform the functions to produce foods, to make the food. Similarly, our mouth will intake the foods to give the energy to the entire bodies, right? So their functions are same, but their structures, they have different structures. Okay, so you see, we also perform, each in the living organisms have many organs. Okay, like for example in plant, root, leaf and stems are different organs. Okay, similarly in animals, stomach, intestines, okay, heart, kidney, lungs are some of the organs. Okay, these different organs will perform, they will try to perform a different function. They will try to perform a different functions. Okay, they will try to perform a different functions. So different organs perform this special function. Like roots are organs which help in observations of the plants, observations of waters and minerals from the soil. Okay, and the leaf are the another organs of the plant which help in synthesizing the foods. Okay, stomach is an organ stomach is an organ for animals. Okay, stomach is an organ especially for animals. Okay, which help in digestion. Similarly, lungs that help in breathings, right? So these different types of organs perform different types of functions. Okay, so here we will discuss about the part of the cells. Under this part of cells, all the plants and animals have a three cell parts, and these three cell parts are known as the cell membrane, cytoplasma and the nucleus. Okay, and this cytoplasma and nucleus are enclosed within the cell membrane. Okay, inside this is your cell membrane. The outer covering is what we call as the cell membrane, that we will discuss more detail again. What is the membrane, what is their function, we will discuss more about in the next slide. Okay, next part. You see, cytoplasma and nucleus are enclosed within, they are present mostly, okay. Like say, if I talk about, let me just draw a diagram out here, you see. So this covering, okay, this is a circle, as this is a cell. This boundary is what we call as a cell membrane. This boundary is what we call as a cell membrane, okay. But a cytoplasma, which is present, okay, cytoplasma, which is cytoplasma, this compound, the open area is what we call as a the open area, that is what we call as a cytoplasma. And inside this, on the cytoplasma, there is another one, that is what we call as a nucleus. That is what we call as a nucleus. And this is what we call as a cytoplasma. Okay, so these are different. And a membrane separate, this cell membrane will separate the cell from another, and also cell from the surrounding. This cell membrane will separate the cell from others, outside, and also what is it? They try to separate from the surrounding regions. Okay, so when you talk about the cell membrane, let's discuss more detail about the cell membrane, then cytoplasma, then nucleus. Okay, you see, a cell membrane, the cell membrane give a set to the cell, protect the inner part of the cell, and allow the movement of the matters in and out of the cell. Okay, what is a cell membrane? That is what also we call as a plasma membrane. Okay, a plasma membrane or a cell membrane, you see, in our cell, there is this membrane are present, this membranes are present. Inside this membrane, there is small pores are present. Okay, this protect us. Okay, this protect the cell from the surrounding. Okay, and then this protect this cytoplasma protect the cell from the surrounding. Okay, and or surround the cell. Okay, or surround the cell, including the nucleus together, consider protoplasma. That is first liquid, and protoplasma in another is what we call also in another word we also consider them as a include them as a cell membrane, cytoplasma, and the nucleus. Okay, cell membranes are also called as a plasma membrane. As I already told you, cell membranes are also known as a plasma membrane. It is very thin skin. Okay, it is very thin skin that cover the cell. They have a very tiny porous inside, and they have a very small hole. Okay, small hole, a tiny holes in the cell membrane. Okay, they have a very small hole inside it. This hole, you see, the cell membrane given cell. Okay, the cell of the cell, and protect the inner part of the whatever the parts are present inside the cell. They protect them from the surrounding. Okay, allow the movements of material in and out. Okay, whatever the material need to be go in, whatever the material need to be move out. This cell membrane having removing or taking in the material from the surrounding. Okay, but in plant cell, the cell membrane is covered by another thick covering, that is what we call a cell, that is what we call as a cell wall. Okay, and the cell wall, okay, the cell walls are mostly very thick covering. Okay, and very rigid, the support and protect to the cell. Okay, you see, this is what we call a plasma membrane, and out of this we have another layers. This is what we call as a this layer. This up to here, this layer is what we call as a cell wall. Okay, the cell walls help in support. They are rigid, support and protect the cell. It also give a cell inside. They also will give a cell inside, and mostly found in the plant. Okay, the cell walls are mostly found in plant and fungi or bacteria. Okay, and surround the plasma membrane. This cell membrane mostly surround the plasma membrane. So what is the functions of the cell membrane? The function of the cell membrane is to protect the cell. The function of the cell membrane is to protect the cell. They provide a sap to the cell, and also what allow the movements of the material in and out of the cell. Okay. Next, we have another one, that is what we call as a cytoplasma. Cyto means hollow, plasma means liquid. Okay. It is totally hollow, and it is hollow, and under this hollow there consists a liquid. Okay. So it is known as a cytoplasma. Okay, a cytoplasma is a jelly substance between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Okay, between the cell membrane and the nucleus, there presents a jelly substance. And that jelly substance is what is called as a cytoplasma. Cytoplasma and jelly-like substances occupying most of the space inside the cell. Okay, it occupies the space between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Okay, so this is what with this open area, this area is what we call as a, this area is what we call as a cytoplasma. This open area is the open field is what we call as a cytoplasma. And on this cytoplasma, there are different other organs. Okay, there are different other organelles are present, and all these organelles, okay, are like mitochondria, Golgi apparatus, Golgi bodies, ribosome, vacuoles. Okay, all these are present here in this and this open its stress. Okay, and all this function take place, all the cell function take place in this cytoplasma. Okay, so next we have another one that is what we call as nucleus. Okay, nucleus, you see, a nucleus is one of the most important, okay, a nucleus is one of the most important part of the cell. Okay, nucleus is one of the most important part of the cell. You see, nucleus mostly present inside the cell, surrounded by the cytoplasm. Nucleus are mostly present inside the cell. Okay, this is your cell membrane. Okay, and this is your cytoplasm. Inside this, you will get a cell's nucleus. Okay, so this nucleus sometimes act like a principles of the school, right? Like a principles. Okay, how? Because the principles try to control everything that take place inside the school. Similarly, the nucleus control every function of the school, of the cell. Okay, the principal used to control every function of the school, right? So similarly, nucleus also control every function of the cell. Okay, so this principle, this nucleus will act like a principle. The nucleus will act like a principles. I hope you are clear about this one. So you see, most of the cell have only one nucleus, or might be, or most of the nucleus, yes, most of the nucleus will have only, most of the cell will have only one nucleus. But muscles, okay, muscle cells have more than one nucleus. Okay, but a red blood cell do not have a nucleus when RBC, okay, our RBC, red blood cell, does not have a nucleus, okay, does not have a nucleus when it become maturity. Okay, when they become maturity, they don't have a nucleus. Okay, you see, nucleus are subdivided into three different parts. One is called nuclear membrane. Okay, nuclear membrane, membrane is covering. Okay, the outer covering layer is called a nuclear membrane. Okay, nuclear membrane, what is it? They will cover up the nucleus, the outer covers. Okay, they cover up the nucleus. Okay, it separate the nucleus from this cytoplasma. This outer cover is what we call as a, like the cell membrane, this nucleus also have a, this is also have a nuclear membrane. Okay, and nucleus also, like the cell, they have a membrane. Okay, that is what we call cell membrane. And like a plasma membrane, and nucleus also have another membrane, what is called as a nuclear membrane. Okay, this nuclear membrane will try to separate the nucleus from the cytoplasma. It have, it also have a tiny small hole, you see. There's a small hole. Okay, this small hole has an extending the substance from the nucleoplasma. This is what we call nucleoplasma. Okay, and this open area is what we call as a cytoplasma. They will have a small hole here. Okay, so they will try to, they will try to extend this through this hole. They will try to extend the substances from the nucleoplasma to cytoplasma. And then we have another one is called nuclear cell or nucleoplasma. That is what this open space is what we call as a nucleoplasma. And this nucleoplasma, like a cytoplasma, they also have a jelly-like substance. Okay, a jelly-like fluid inside the nucleus is what we call as nucleoplasma. And chromosome and nuclei are present in this chromosome. All this chromosome, this is what you can see. You see the graph, like this, like a reborn. All this graph are what you call as a chromosomes. Okay, all this are present inside, and this is what we call as a nucleoid. Okay, nucleoid. Okay, so this nucleoid is present inside the nucleus. Okay, the another one is, what is it? Nucleus, it is the smallest spherical body present in the nucleus. It is the smallest spherical body present inside the nucleus. Okay, so next is what we call as a chromosome. A chromosome is thread-like structures. Okay, what is a chromosome? A chromosome is a thread-like structures. Okay, they are thread-like structures. They try to, okay, they try to carry the numbers of genes. Okay, they have a numbers of genes. Okay, and these genes, and the chromosome and gene plays the importance, okay, the important role, like inheritance of character from one generation to another. Inheritance of character means like if I say you look exactly like your father, your parents, right? Why? That is what the character it is. Okay, the way you behave, or the way you reacted, or your facial appearance. Okay, all these are the character that are inherited from our parents. Okay, and all these characters, okay, are been recorded by the chromosomes, and in like to inherit them to the new offspring. Okay, so these chromosomes have been inheritance, have been transferring the character from your father generation to you, or from you to your child generations, or whatever it is. Okay, so this chromosome having, okay, and this chromosome can only seen when the cell get divided, when the cell get divided. Okay, so these are all about the three different parts of the cell. So what is the functions of the nucleus? The functions of the nucleus is what they transmit of the character from one generation to another. Next is what the next function is what they control all the life function that takes place inside the cell. Clear about this one? Now I believe you are clear about all those topic, okay? And you try to be very clear about this. Okay, next we will discuss, in the next video lectures, we will discuss about the organelles of the cell. And under this organelle, we will discuss six different types of organelle. And which is very much important for your next class, that is class 9. Okay, in your class 9, you will have one chapter, okay? On the name of the chapter is Fundamental Units of Life. Okay, so in this chapter, you will discuss more about this organelle. But still, I will try to make it some point clears about it so that you will proceed to the next slide with clears and clarity. You will proceed to the next slide with some ideas. Okay, so I want you to be very clear about you try. I want you to watch up the video lectures, okay, again and again, and try to clear up your doubts. Okay, anyway, let's see up in the next video lectures. Okay.